In this part, we will talk about the model of plasma membrane, which was proposed by Danieli and Davison. Danieli and Davison. And they called their model as sandwich model. So this is the one which we are discussing first. It is sandwich model of plasma membrane. And after we understand the model, we will also realize why this term sandwich model was given to their model. Danieli and Davison, they put forth certain points. So we will first take up those points which were given by them, and then using those points we'll draw the structure of the plasma membrane. The first point was that plasma membrane is made up of proteins and phospholipids. The second information which they gave was about proteins. Proteins are alpha globular proteins. Alpha globular means they're spherical proteins. Then about phospholipid, that phospholipid molecules are amphipathic. They are amphipathic. This term was given by them for the phospholipid molecules. Now let us come to this phospholipid. Each phospholipid is made up of a glycerol head. So this is glycerol head. And there are two fatty acid chains attached to it. So these are fatty acid chains. And attached to the glycerol molecule, there is phosphate. And that is how it becomes phospholipid. This is a diglyceride fat. In diglyceride fat, two fatty acids are attached to one glycerol molecule. So this is diglyceride fat, and a phosphate is attached to it. So we call it phospholipid. Now what exactly is an amphipathic molecule? Amphipathic molecule is one molecule in which one end is hydrophilic and the other end is hydrophobic. Due to glycerol and this phosphate here, the head part becomes hydrophilic. This end is hydrophilic. Whereas the fatty acid tails, they are hydrophobic. So, one end is hydrophilic, other end is hydrophobic. Such a molecule is called amphipathic molecule. So, what Danieli and Davison told us about proteins and phospholipid is that proteins are globular and phospholipids are amphipathic molecule. Then they also explained the arrangement of these phospholipids. Phospholipids are arranged in a bilayer. Bilayer means there are two layers which are there. And the arrangement is such in this bilayer that phospholipids are arranged in a bilayer in such a manner that tails of the molecule face towards each other. That tails face each other. Obviously, if the tails are facing each other, then the heads are going to be away from each other. So this was the explanation given by Danieli and Davison. The tails, when they're facing towards each other, there's a weak force, van der Waal force, which attracts them. So here we will write the force which was helping these two layers to stay together was a weak force of van der Waal. So it is called van der Waal's force, weak force. Using this information, we are going to draw the diagram. Before that, we will write one more thing. The proteins, alpha globular, are arranged on either side of the phospholipid bilayer. Proteins are on either side of phospholipid bilayer. Now with this information, let us make this diagram. Phospholipid molecules, we are just not making the phosphate here, just the phospholipid molecule head and the tails, and as mentioned by Danieli and Davson, the tails are facing each other in case of two layers. So this is the phospholipid bilayer. Phospholipid bilayer. And to hold them together between these two layers, there's a weak force of attraction which is called van der Waal force. And about the protein, it was mentioned that the proteins are present on either side of the bilayer. They're globular proteins, so we are going to make them spherical here on this side of the plasma membrane as well as on the other side of the plasma membrane. So this is the protein, this also is the protein, and the protein is globular, that's why we have made it spherical. This is the structure of plasma membrane according to Danieli and Davson. Let us check, it is made up of proteins and phospholipid. Proteins are alpha globular, so we have made them spherical. Phospholipid molecules are amphipathic. We have understood what amphipathic means. Arrangement is such that phospholipids are arranged in two layers, bilayer. But the arrangement is that the tails face each other, the heads are away from each other. To hold them together, there is a weak force of attraction called van der Waal force. And the protein is on either side of it. Now, does it look like a sandwich? When we make a sandwich, there are two slices of bread and we put a thick layer of jam in between. So here, there is one layer of protein, other layer of protein, and the phospholipid bilayer is placed in between. So based on the structure, the model was called sandwich model. Now, the time to check whether this model explains the properties of plasma membrane or not. If it explains, we will accept it. If it is not able to explain the properties, then we would be rejecting it. Let us start with the first property. The first property is that plasma membrane is selectively permeable. It allows the entry of fat-soluble as well as water-soluble substances. So say this is a fat-soluble substance. Can this come in? Fat-soluble substance can cross the protein. Protein is not creating any problem for it. Coming to the head region, there is no problem because we have written about hydro. Hydro is water. Hydrophilic means water loving. It is going to let water come closer. And hydrophobic is water hating or repelling. It's not going to let the water come closer. So it is in relation to water, not in relation to fat. So fat soluble substance comes here. This middle band is made up of fatty acids. Fatty acid, obviously it is also fatty thing, so it will not create any problem. So this fat soluble substance has moved into the cell, no problem. So first point, clarified, explained. Coming to the second part of this first point, will this membrane allow the entry of water-soluble substances? This is a water-soluble substance. Water-soluble substance comes to the protein part, no problem created by protein. Head part is hydrophilic. It is going to let water come closer, so that means water can cross the head region part also. What about this part? That is the tail part, only tail part. It is hydrophobic. That means this band is hydrophobic. And if it is hydrophobic, it would not let water or water-soluble substances come closer. So water-soluble substances cannot cross this model. And we know that water also goes into the cell, plus there are substances which are soluble in water. They also go into the cell. Water is essential for survival. So cells need water, and if they are able to survive, that means water is going in. And this model does not show that. So this is one point where it is rejected. We will check it on the other point also. The other point was variable protein to phospholipid ratio. Say we take this much part of the membrane just for our calculation purpose, and we find out the ratio of proteins to phospholipids. How many proteins? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are 6 proteins here. 1, 2, 3, 4 phospholipids. Ratio is going to change only if either the protein moves from its place or the phospholipid moves from its place. Danieli and Davison did not mention any of those things. They were not talking about movement of protein, nor they mentioned the movement of phospholipids. So if they don't move from their place, how is this ratio going to change? So second point also, this model was not able to explain. And if nothing moves, that means it is a rigid structure. And if it is rigid, it is static, not dynamic. So this model actually fails on all three points. It was not able to explain the entry of water-soluble substances. It was not able to explain the variable protein to phospholipid ratio. And it was also not able to explain the dynamic nature of our plasma membrane. And that is why this model got rejected. But still, we have discussed this model in detail. And the reason is, whatever information they gave, that is all this information, is absolutely correct. Only thing is, their interpretation was not up to the mark. When we come to the next models, we'll see how scientists have used the same information and interpreted it in a different manner to give the other models, which are successful. They were able to explain all the properties. So this is the first sandwich model which was given, and this is the one which we are talking. First means not the first model. Out of three which we are going to discuss, this was the first one. The next one is unit membrane model, which we will take up in the next part.